Certainly. Thank you. Again, Marsha Hultman, Secretary of the Department of Labor and Regulation. And we are going about doing all the other business we're responsible for, but our primary function and focus has been on getting payments to individuals who are eligible for unemployment insurance in the state. And some very common questions, some updates that I have from the last time I visited with you. One thing that's been very much in the press is individuals are eligible for an additional $600 in a federal benefit. And we just received the guidance on that Saturday at 10 p.m. So we're working diligently to get the coding done so we can make that payment. We do believe that we'll be able to start issuing those payments for the work week ending this Saturday. So that is coming. There's nothing additional individuals need to do to request that payment. If you have filed and are deemed eligible for unemployment insurance, that is automatically added to your state benefit. So again, not necessary to call or request or refile. It's all taken care of through your initial claim. Additionally, there's been a lot of press, a lot of news talking about individuals that typically are not eligible for assistance that under the COVID-19 CARES Act will now be eligible. And those are individuals like small business owners, independent contractors, gig workers. So anybody that may fall in that category and has had a cessation in work or a closure related to the COVID-19 may now be eligible. The guidance for this program, and it is called Pandemic Unemployment Assistance, and we will refer to it as PUA, but I hate to get lost in acronyms. But we received the guidance for that program at 10 o'clock last night. So again, we're working diligently. We are not yet taking claims for that particular program. So anybody that's an independent contractor, small business owner, et cetera, should wait. We will be out in front of the press to every extent possible to let individuals know when they can start filing those claims. But for right now, please hold off from calling our call center. Speaking of our call center, good news to report today. When we started this, we had approximately 11 people on a normal day that were answering phones and taking claims. And you've all seen the increase in initial claims and can understand what that's done to volume. We have added capacity starting late last week that we have an additional 50 to 60 people answering phones at any one time. Our wait times have been greatly reduced today. I don't want to jinx us, but great improvements there. So now we need to continue moving those claims through the process to make sure everybody gets the benefit that they may be eligible for. With that, I've had questions. We have not hired any new people to take this on. We have reassigned, redirected existing staff to take on these responsibilities. It was easiest, as they had some base knowledge on the system, to get them up to speed and be able to help us with that process. Just one last point I want to make that's really important. Quitting work without good cause to obtain UI benefits is considered fraud. If your employer has work available for you and you quit or decide to stay home, you may not be eligible for benefits. So it's really important to remember you can't just decide to self-quarantine. You can't quit without a verified medical reason to be doing so. Also, if you've been laid off and your employer calls you back and you refuse to return to work, you could also lose that state benefit and that additional federal benefit.